Using Microsoft Word and Excel to create merged labels. Hi everybody, Kyle here from Mizzou's IT Training, and today I want to show you how to quickly and easily make mailing labels using Microsoft Excel and Microsoft Word. So as you can see here in Microsoft Excel, I have a list of addresses that I wish to mail to, and over here in Microsoft Word is where I'll be creating those mailing labels using the Mailings tab found here. First, I'll need to choose which kind of labels I wish to use. So from the Mailings tab, I click on the Start Mail Merge button and then choose Labels. This brings up a dialog box that will let me choose which tray in the printer that I'm going to put the labels in, as well as the vendor and model number of the specific label that I am using. So you'll need to check on your box of labels to find out what the vendor and model number are of the specific label that you are using. Avery is a very popular vendor, and so we'll use one of their labels. We'll click OK. Once we have the label chosen correctly, we're going to want to link this Word document with the Excel document that contains the addresses. So again, from the Mailings tab, we'll choose the Select Recipients button, and then because I already have that list waiting, I will use an existing list. You browse your computer to find the existing list, and then you'll also need to choose which sheet from that workbook we are going to use. Now we can begin to build our prototype label. So from the Insert Merge Fields button here in the Mailings tab, I can go in and just insert my merge fields, inserting spaces and line breaks wherever necessary to make it look like a proper address. So we'll put in city, state, and zip. And now here it's obvious that I have too much space between lines and it's cutting off part of one of my labels. So I'm going to select all the fields in this prototype label on all the lines, click the Home tab, and then in the Line Spacing button here in the center of the ribbon, I want to choose Remove Space Before Paragraph. That will take out any extra space between lines and will leave you with a proper looking label. Now that I have my prototype label built, I'll want to see what they all look like. So I'll click back on the Mailings tab. I need to be sure to click on the Update Labels button so that my prototype format is updated on all the labels. And once that is done, then I can click on the Finish and Merge button. Now if I choose Print Documents from here, it will send these finished labels direct to the printer, but I can choose Edit Individual Documents to see what they look like before I click the Print button. So we'll choose Edit Individual Documents, Merge Records All, and click OK. And now what we have is a finished page of labels that are ready to print. So assuming we have the labels on the printer, we go to the File tab and click Print. And that's all there is to it. Thanks for watching. Be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel and go to training.missouri.edu to register for an in-person class.